welcome to Wine Uncorked with Tower. My name is Gil Coolers, and I'm a wine consultant here at Tower Beer, Wine, and Spirits in Atlanta, Georgia. This week, we're going to do something a little different. We reached out to our Instagram friends, asking them for their most interesting questions related to wine. Question number one from someone here in the city of Atlanta. Which wines have the highest alcohol percentage? Well, that really has a lot to do more with the environment where the grape is grown. Essentially, alcohol is actually related to sunshine. So the more sunshine you have, the more sugar development you have in your grapes, which in turn relates to how much alcohol is concerned. So more sunshine, more sugar, more alcohol. Question number two. This question is from a lady from Decatur, Georgia. What foods would you prefer pairing with red wines? Well, that's kind of a personal question. I believe you should drink whatever wine that floats your boat makes you happy with any kind of food that also makes you happy. But I have contemplated this question before, just in case I ever get put on death row. One of my favorite wine pairings that I could ever think of is a perfectly roasted chicken with truffled risotto with a beautiful red Burgundy, or really any Pinot Noir will do for me. And I think if I'm gonna go out of this world with one last meal, I think it would be chicken risotto and a Pinot Noir. All right, next question. How long is a bottle of wine good for after it is opened? That is a question I get quite a lot. And I'm gonna start off a little sciencey, but hang on, because I'm gonna bring it around and tell you what to do in a second. So the culprit of what happens to a wine after you open it that we don't care for is something called acetobacter and a few of its friends that produce volatile acidity. A lot of us know this as vinegar. Acetobacter needs three things. It needs a fairly high pH environment, it needs alcohol, and it needs oxygen. It's an aerobe, or an organism that needs oxygen to exist. So when a wine is in the bottle, it only has two out of the three things. It's lacking the oxygen. Once you take that cork out, oxygen comes into the mix, and we have this acetobacter and, like I said, other volatile acid producing bacteria that ruin a wine over time. So oxygen is the enemy here. And what we can do is a couple of things. I think the easiest thing, and even if it's a red wine, is after you open it up and say you want to have it in a day or two or three after, just put that cork back in and put it in the fridge. That slows down the metabolism of the bacteria. And that is all the questions we have for today. I want to thank you for watching, and thank you for shopping at Tower. Oh, and don't forget, send in your wine questions to me, and I'll do the best I can to answer them, but you gotta follow us on Instagram. Thanks very much.